Today we're talking about Cartoon Moblur. What is it? How does it work? Does it work? All those questions and more will be answered. I was working on a corporate video for PayPal and we had some very simple looping graphics and I wanted to add just a little bit of extra visual jazz to them. And so, like many After Effects artists, I applied the echo effect to create sort of motion trail or cartoon smear. The result looked good, but the problem, as everyone who's used echo knows, is if the layer is moving and then stops moving, all the copies of the echo start to build up one atop the other and create this really crunchy, disgusting pixelated edge. And you can base the echo effect on the velocity of your layer via expressions, but at this time I was an After Effects noob and, well, not a noob, but I was just terrified of expressions, so I didn't bother, you know, opening that mystical box. I just did it manually. As soon as the layer stops moving, I turned the opacity of the echo effect down to zero to basically stop it from getting too crunchy. I'm guessing that the echo effect for After Effects wasn't made with this purpose in mind to create this motion trail. I'm imagining that it was more made for creating like acid trip sequences or, you know, Frodo puts the ring on, you know, that very ethereal look, wide time look. And I think it's pretty evident based on the controls that the Echo has that it's not meant for motion trails. Just the controls don't feel intuitive for that purpose. So when I learned how to make plugins, I thought, wouldn't it be cool if I made a plugin that was kind of like the Echo effect, but custom built, specifically made to create these cartoon motion trails. And thus, Cartoon Moblur was birthed out of my birth canal. So the very first version of Cartoon Moblur that we released was actually using a very silly method to do. Under the hood, it was using a very silly method. Essentially, if you had a layer that then rotated 15 degrees, it would copy that input, the rotated input, then essentially rotate it the other way to reverse the transform, and that created the motion trail. The problem with that is that because we're dealing with layer transforms and matrices, anyone who's used a matrix knows that it gets pretty complicated pretty quickly, especially with, you know, multiple separate transforms, particularly parented transforms. And because of that, actually, version 1 was not compatible with parented transforms or 3D layers, because the vanilla After Effects SDK does not have any functionality for you to transform layers in any 3D way. So the very first version was kind of limited. As every After Effects user knows, parenting is a massive thing. You can't really do any complex kind of animations without that. And so it was kind of met with a lukewarm reception. I took that feedback on board and within, I think, the first month, quickly rewrote the entire plugin using a much smarter method, which I should have used at the start. Essentially, if your layer is, you know, rotating, don't take the rotated layer and rotate it back. Just get the buffer of the layer at different times when it was rotating, and then just layer them one atop the other. Plugin is looking for the velocity of your transforms, and depending on how much your layer transforms, it's going to take copies at different times and just layer them atop each other. And that's a much simpler, cleaner method. It allows for parented transforms. It also allows for 3D transforms, because I'm just taking a 2D buffer of pixels rather than, you know, the pixels and then having to undo the transforms. And so that was met with a lot better reception. And I think a lot of users have created some really cool stuff with Cartoon Moblur. I think maybe it was kind of like, you know, a trend in motion design that's sort of passed a little bit, but I think it's still, you know, if not overdone, still looks very effective, and it's a great way to take a simple animation and make it way cooler. A common issue with Cartoon Moblur, and to an even greater extent the echo effect, is these samples that build up if there is no transformation, or Certain transformations like a rotation, depending on where the anchor point is, just say the anchor point is here, this part of the image is going to be moving a lot, but this part is not moving at all because the anchor point is here. And so all the samples build up and create these disgusting crunchy edges, and there's really no solution for that. You can apply a blur to it, but then it just looks blurry. You can apply like a 2-pixel blur, but it just looks too soft. But thankfully, a user on our beta program, Chris, kept complaining about this, and I had to think about it. And there is a very smart guy at Nvidia called Timothy Lotz who developed an algorithm which is basically designed to kill stair-stepping. It's called FXAA, or fast, it's called fast approximate anti-aliasing. And so we have taken that algorithm and implemented into a standalone After Effects plugin, which will be released, should be released shortly after this video is live. And essentially, it just analyzes the different pixels and detects where stair-stepping is, and then it intelligently smooths or blends it to remove that disgusting artifact. I think that has been the biggest complaint among Cartoon Moblur users, is that is a problem that needs to be addressed. And so thankfully we have a solution to that that we stole from the internet, but that's how the internet works these days. We're actually running a competition at the moment, which is send us your coolest Cartoon Moblur GIF that you've made, and the winner, which we will announce shortly afterwards, will receive a free copy of Cartoon Moblur, which is great because you've already bought it and now you get another copy. No, just kidding, we'll give you a copy of Deep Glow. If you've already bought that, too bad, that's what you're getting. That's it for this episode. Don't send in your support tickets, as always, just keep them bottled up, and thanks for watching.